Hello and welcome to segment three of Citizens Forum, being filmed on Tuesday, June the 16th in the Memorial Arena, Victoria, BC. I'd like to thank again the volunteer crew and the Shaw staff that makes this program happen every week. Our guest in this segment is Norm Ryder. Norm has been working on work safe issues for a few years because you were injured, and I think I can say we're not happy with the way you were treated with work safe. By WorkSafe. Can you just say a few words about WorkSafe? But what I'd like to know is, who do they really protect?
I don't know who they protect, because employers aren't happy with them. And over the last few months, I've been meeting with a lot of people that have had problems with WorkSafe as employees or workers. And clearly, a great many workers are not being protected, that I don't really know who WorkSafe works for. That
I know if you have, because over the years, I've known people who've gotten hurt at work, small injuries, a broken arm, you know, a sore back for a month or two. And WorkSafe takes very good care of those people at that level. A lot of, you know, they take, I think, good care of you. But for people who are really injured and are going to be off work for a long time, and I think with those people, like yourself, WorkSafe doesn't want to.
No, they don't. They have a pattern of literally creating incorrect information that you have to fight against on the file, and just generally doing as much as they can to cause stress for a person applying for WorkSafe. Now, you have to realize that people that are generally in that position are not in a position to go out and hire lawyers. Not that lawyers will work on the case, because most lawyers have found that WorkSafe's rules are just not the same as the normal legal system's rules, and it takes a tremendous amount of time, and there just isn't the money in it.
Well, that's really interesting, because I was hit by a bus a few years ago, and there's no shortage of great lawyers out there who will take on personal injury cases with ICBC. But you're saying that nobody will dare take on WorkSafe,
essentially,
which is interesting.
Because it's such a crazy system where their whole standard of evidence that they require from you when you submit your evidence about your claim, you have to be very careful about peer-reviewed, appropriate medical authorities. And WorkSafe will counter with, "We don't believe." That is their solid proof, is that they don't believe, and your entire argument is thrown out according to them.
So their argument of "we don't believe you" is trumps everything else.
That trumps everything.
Okay. So I think what's needed is for a real public overview of, because we know nothing about WorkSafe. I mean, we know the work they did. There were some sawmill explosions, and supposedly, I mean, you know, you read about it in the paper, the story goes in one ear and out the other, but the story was, I think, that they bungled the investigation so badly that charges could not be laid. Am I getting that right or wrong?
Yeah, that's quite right. Unfortunately, that's just one example of how WorkSafe operates in their own world, that they are accountable to no one. That what I learned the other day about WorkSafe is they are the only government agency of any description in D.C. that makes their own regulations, and Cabinet doesn't have to sign off on it. That they're accountable to no one, and they make that quite clear when you try and deal with them, that you cannot go above them. When you got hit by a bus, if you weren't happy with the situation, you could ultimately take it to the Supreme Court of Canada. With WorkSafe, it is almost impossible to get it into the court system. That they have a special set of laws and regulations that allow them to do as they wish.
You know, that's very scary, because WorkSafe actually plays a very important role in our society, which is, I think, to make sure that workers, employees, are not put in excessive danger by the action of the employer. Is that, you know, things have got to be safe. But if
I'd say they do that sometimes, but in other times I've seen situations where WorkSafe will not do anything about I had a construction crew that had people down in river sand on a flood tide. There's a lot of silt seams in the sand, so the banks would cave in, and people were working down 12 feet. They were going to 12, the hole was going to be 20 feet deep in the end. An excavator ramped down working on one side with these people in the hole and heavy equipment driving around the hole and no shoring. Now, the WorkSafe regulations say at 4 feet, you have to have shoring. Now, they were down well over 12 feet, and I couldn't get any action out of WorkSafe on that. Now, that's just stupid to put people down there.
But maybe that's really WorkSafe's job, is to ensure that very, very lax standards are there. And when people, I mean, they seem to run their own show.
Lost my job over that because I couldn't get them out. And WorkSafe did nothing to help me.
So you mean you lost your job because you were trying to get WorkSafe to enforce their rules?
It's some crazy idea that they were just temporary workers. I should have, obviously, they had no rights. I should have left them there, I guess. Yeah.
So wow. That's what's going on in the real world. And on our watch, as they like to say in the war movies. And we don't even know about it. And WorkSafe, which is supposed to be, you know, we think the arm of government that's, I mean, WorkSafe, right? It used to be Workers' Compensation Board. I think really it just needs a very public, some fresh air blowing through there, and the public has to know.
Well, that's one of the things I'm working on, is that we can go through and analyze my case and how they've done it wrong, but that's not going to help the next person because WorkSafe's pattern is so entrenched, and the public has to realize and get together that how they're treating people is just not acceptable. It's, you're almost as though you've got the police investigation, the judge, the jury, and the executioner and the crown prosecutor all rolled into one package that...
And your defense attorney as well.
Yeah, and your defense attorney as well. And you have almost no place that you can turn many times that... To deal with it, because if the case is too complex, you get no assistance from Workers' Advisor's Office, or very little.
So you're left to deal with WorkSafe.
Yes.
Yeah, you as an amateur and them as, it's like playing tennis for your life against the professional. I mean, what are the chances you're going to win? It's just not going to happen. So what is the constant pattern?
The constant pattern is their misuse of information that they regularly have, that they recreate facts many times flatly refuse to accept medical evidence, which is very clearly on file. As a matter of fact, in some cases, even their own doctors discovered it, and it gets quietly disappeared.
Say that again?
I know of one case where a woman had an injury that resulted in chronic pain. The WorkSafe doctor noticed it, and then she was on the hook to have to prove it properly after that. So, I mean, even they diagnosed what the problem was.
I didn't understand that.
Yeah, well, they, if they don't like their own diagnosis, they'll bury it.
Oh, you mean WorkSafe doctor said, yes, this was...
And of course, if your doctor comes in with something they don't like, it obviously he's an incompetent fool.
So, how many people is this impacting?
I don't know, but I'd say probably a third of the WorkSafe claims are ones where the people are very unhappy with the way their claim has been denied.
And I guess there's a lot of WorkSafe claims.
Yeah,
You know, just from the stories you've told and things I've seen in the paper that you read and hear about, I think WorkSafe does play an important role in our society.
It could.
Well, it does. It does. I mean, it's there to do a job, an important job. If it's not doing it, I mean, people get hurt at work. And I think we've got to have a very, very fair, open and public process to make sure that those people are treated well. It doesn't make sense to do anything else. I mean, we've got to know the truth, and we've got to have, like you're saying, how difficult it is to go to court. Well, the courts very often do stand up for what's right, and if you can't even go there.
Yeah. That's, in a sense, what really concerns me more than anything, is that there is just no way to take the issue out of WorkSafe and have it dealt with before ones that at least are there to be independent arbitrators.
That's impossible. That cannot... I mean, we know, just from living our own lives, that if they are the judge, jury, and executioner, you're not going to get a fair shake. I mean, you need a completely outside body to oversee these people. Anything else is crazy.
Yeah.
Who are the big contributors to WorkSafe?
Pardon?
Who are the big contributors? The big construction companies, mining companies, the logging industry?
In total, employers pay about $800 million a year to WorkSafe to operate.
Norm, we're out of time. We'll try again to shed a little more light on this in the future. Thanks very much.
And
thank you for watching this segment of Citizens Forum.